Russian court has ordered the Putin opposition leader Alexei Navalny to spend more than 2.5 years in prison. He appeared in court today in a glass cage. The sentence comes from an embezzlement conviction back in 2014. Police arrested Alexei Navalny last month after he returned to Russia for the first time since somebody poisoned him last summer. He claims Vladimir Putin was behind that botched assassination. Navalny's arrest triggered demonstrations in major cities across Russia. Officers reportedly arrested more than 5,000 people over the weekend. Authorities had warned the rallies were illegal. For more on Navalny's sentence, here's NBC's Matthew Bodner.
Well, there's a lot of things that we can say about what happened today, but for me, what sticks out is the performance of Alexei Navalny in court. He brought with him this very characteristic sense of humor, mocking the proceedings throughout, but he also brought with him this really profound, fiery sense of defiance and gave this remarkable courtroom speech in which he said the only thing he's guilty of is surviving an assassination attempt and then returning to Russia to show Vladimir Putin, the man that Navalny says ordered that assassination attempt, to show that he's not afraid. And throughout the hearing, he kept referring to Putin as this old man sitting and hiding in a bunker. Meanwhile, outside of the court, the scene was no less dramatic. The Russian opposition staged a rally outside of the court. The police response was strong. About 300 were arrested by the end of this 9-hour court hearing today. And then they continued into the city after the verdict was issued, where they were met by an even more significant police response as vast parts of the city center went into a security lockdown. Now, it is obvious at this point that the Russian opposition will continue to protest for his release. This will definitely be a rallying cry. But the big question now is what Western governments will do, what they can do. We saw very swift rounds of condemnations from most Western governments, including the United States, the new Secretary of State, Antony Blinken, condemning it and calling for his release. But again, this big question is, what can the West do and will they do it? Shep?
Shepard Smith here. Thanks for watching CNBC on YouTube.